insects undergo extreme morphological changes during their life cycle, from the time they hatch out of their eggs till they become adults. I assume many of you know the lovely book The Hungry Caterpillar that beautifully describes the life cycle of butterflies. We will here go now into a little more detail. Insects have a rigid external skeleton that protects them, stabilizes their body and prevents dehydration. This exoskeleton, however, restricts their growth and development. To grow and evolve, insects and other arthropods have to replace their skeleton by molting multiple times. Insect metamorphosis appeared and became more complex during evolution and might have been an important factor in their remarkable success. Few primitive insects undergo no metamorphosis. A large group undergoes partial metamorphosis, and the most modern insects undergo complete metamorphosis. The groups that undergo partial metamorphosis include cockroaches, grasshoppers, and true bugs like these Oncopeltus seed bugs. Young Oncopeltus that hatch from their eggs look already like tiny versions of adults and have most of their adult organs. Their habitat and food also resemble that of adults. The major difference is that larvae lack wings and can't reproduce. Such insects that undergo partial metamorphosis grow incrementally and undergo a series of moltings. When they reach the adult stage, they have wings and reproductive organs and stop growing and molting. More evolutionary advanced insects, butterflies, flies, mosquitoes, beetles, bees, and additional groups undergo complete metamorphosis. Larvae look totally different than adults and in most cases have a very different diet and lifestyle. The small larva that hatches from the egg looks a bit like a worm with legs. It eats and grows until it reaches the appropriate size. It next forms a pupa and covers itself with a protective cocoon. In most cases, pupa are sessile. However, in mosquitoes, the pupa are active, free-swimming tumblers. Inside the cocoon, the pupa undergoes a dramatic change. Larval structures are broken down and completely new ones grow from imaginal discs. After weeks, months, or even years, the adult imago emerges with wings and sex organs. Insects belong to arthropods that consist of additional groups: scorpions, centipedes, crabs, and spiders. Most crabs continue to molt and grow all their life and have no finite size. When millipedes and centipedes like this venomous Scolopendra hatch from their eggs, they don't have yet all their legs. As they grow and mold, they add additional pairs of legs until they reach a very large, though not unlimited, number. Spiders, in contrast, do have a finite growth size.